Hi.
Thanks.
Hello.
Thanks, Academy. I just said without saying that that's the name of the... How do you do this sentence? Hi, welcome to Thanks Academy, the podcast. You're nodding. You're being so encouraging. Welcome to Thanks Academy, the podcast where we watch all the best picture winners in random order with random friends. And today's random friend is a very special guest from out of town. It's Vanessa Gonzalez.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. Am I from out of town, technically? Yeah.
Yeah, sort of.
I feel dumb because I'm always here.
You are here delightfully often. But I feel like you've earned the right to seem cooler than you're from here.
Okay.
Because
I spend more time away.
Exactly.
Got it.
Have you had to change your driver's license yet?
Not yet.
Don't do it.
I don't want to.
No.
I'm very much like, I want to do, like, I don't want to accept the fact that I've moved.
Yeah.
Where like, I'm like, no, like, I haven't set up anything in my room. It's all bare. I'm like, I'm not going to be here a long time.
I hope you come back.
Maybe I'll decorate a little bit, but yeah. I'm just like, this is not home. And I keep telling my roommate that too.
I think that is the culture of Los Angeles. I think that aesthetic of this isn't home.
Yeah.
I don't know how long I'll be here.
Right.
I'm ready to go.
Yeah. That's how I feel. I love it. And that's why I'm always like, I'm going back to Austin like every month or so.
That's nice.
Yeah.
It's been kind of awesome. I feel like California too, but I don't remember exactly because when I lived there, I got my license right away because I was coming back from out of the country, but they are much more relaxed than Texas. Texas is if you still have your old license after a year, you're literally going to jail for some reason.
Really?
Yeah, they're really intense about it.
Oh,
you didn't.
I didn't know that.
You haven't had to deal with that 1 year expiration.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it's scary.
That's why I'm like, I'll keep it Texas then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, they don't know. I go everywhere, you know, I buy weed and they're like, fine, whatever, ID. Like, they don't care.
Yeah, they don't. They really don't. Like, I think California's passed a lot of laws making IDs superfluous to existence as just a middle finger to Texas.
Yeah.
Who thinks that we should have more of them?
It's dumb.
Like a brand on our butts.
Yeah. I know. It does. Yeah. They're like, we need to have you on record.
Exactly.
Yeah. California. They don't even have pictures on theirs. It's like, sure.
What would you, they're like checks from like Bank of America. Would you like seals or whales?
Right. Yeah. Everyone has like either their headshot on it or a drawing of their favorite actor.
Your headshot is your actual ID in California. That's your real proof of existence.
Right. Mm-hmm. Like how many credits you have.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep. Or like, you know, north of, I don't know, north of like mid county, like north of, let's say San Luis Obispo. There's the dividing
line.
So
middle.
South of San Luis Obispo, headshot, north of there. It used to be medical marijuana license, but now you don't need that anymore. Yeah. So I guess just tech resume.
Right? And then I'm fucked there because I don't.
No.
And well, I worked at U-Ship for a bit.
That's true. So you're fine.
That's why it's 6 months.
You're good.
Yeah.
They're a company nobody understands how they make money. That counts.
Yeah. That's exactly what tech companies are.
Thank you for sustaining so many comedians, U-Ship.
Yeah, I know.
That seems to be your purpose.
Right. It's like they're good. They're treating the comedy scene well.
They really are. They're brought to you by U-Ship.
Right.
In a lot
great.
Of ways. I think half of my guests on the podcasts
have worked there.
Have or are currently getting a paycheck from them. So.
Right. Or are applying.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's good. It's a good gig.
Oh wait, this is a movie podcast.
Oh right. Oh yeah, we're talking about movies.
What
too.
Are we gonna watch today?
We're watching American Beauty.
No, we're not.
You forgot.
We are watching American Beauty.
Or we can watch a different one.
No, it's fine. Yeah. I complained for a while, like the first dozen episodes, they were all old movies.
Yeah.
And I was like, when am I going to get a movie? Because I draw them randomly, right? I was like, when am I going to get a movie I actually remember? And now I'm getting nothing but Weinstein movies. And I'm like, oh, this is complicated now.
I know.
It's ruined. And I'm like, well, I don't remember if this is a Weinstein movie or not, but
it feels like it.
Well, it has Kevin Spacey.
Right.
Who's somehow worse. Or not worse, right. But...
Well, it's weird because
he's like, worse because then we have to look at him right. for 2 hours, not just think, oh, this was made by a bad man. It's like, there's the bad man.
Right.
Yeah.
And like, he's... It's like, so he likes teenage boys?
He likes not having boundaries.
So yeah. He's a pedophile?
I think, yeah. I think but he engaged in some light pedophilia. Like, well, like his victim was 16, 17. Oh. So we're not talking Republican pedophilia. Right. With like 8 and 9 year olds.
Right. Okay. So more liberal.
More liberal pedophilia. Right,
okay. Yeah, because I was like, I'm like, are these like 14 year old, 13? Because I'm like,
I could have my facts mixed. That, you know what?
I don't know.
There were so many people during the Me Too movement and still are. They're just keeping track of who they are is eating up some of my. I'm just forgetting the details of why.
Right.
I'm just like, I remember reading and going, okay, you're off.
Right.
And that's all I'm going to keep in my head.
Right.
With Kevin Spacey, I think the thing that stuck out for me was the fact that he like got caught and then he was like, well, now I'm gay.
Right.
Anyway, our pizza just got here.
Right.
Let's go get it.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, hi, we're eating now.
We're eating pizza.
It wasn't Kevin Spacey at the door.
No, it wasn't. We were talking shit.
I mean, can we be mean to him now?
Yeah.
Because he kind of has a pizza face.
He does. He does.
He looks like a pizza delivery driver.
Yeah. Well, in this movie,
like mean one.
He works at like a drive-thru, like a McDonald's or something.
That's right. I forgot about that.
I remember that.
Oh, all I remember about this movie is that there's teenage boobies in it, which in retrospect seems problematic extra.
What I was remembering, I was like, does this movie make you root for this guy that likes a teenager and you like kind of, and it's like, wait, but that's not cool.
I know. I think this has that like, because this is 99, 98.
Yeah.
It's got that 90s thing going on where, oh, well, it's a white guy, so we have to root for him.
Right. But look how sad his life is. He just wants that teenage girl to like him. Like, yeah, like
he just needs a spark of life.
Right.
He just needs someone to come along and reignite his purpose for living, because otherwise he'll be sad.
Right. Yeah. And it's like, yeah, that's like the big scary thing in the movie. It's sadness.
Yeah, I think so, if I remember. Because like the teenage boy, he's also sad. He made a movie of a bag.
Right.
That I remember.
That was real sad. It's real sad.
And that's kind of, I don't really remember the details of the plot. I remember all the things that kind of get parodied, like the Rose Dream and the bag and Kevin Spacey working out at one point.
Right.
I think. To try to, you know, feel not sad.
Yeah, it's everything to, like, fight sadness.
He gets pot.
Oh, yeah, he smokes weed.
That's why he's not sad anymore.
Yeah, because he starts acting young.
Mm-hmm, 'cause that's what pot does.
Right.
It doesn't make you old and forgetful.
And it's, like, 'cause he smokes pot now, it's okay that he has sex with a teenage girl.
Right, because he's young.
Right.
Like, the age difference just melts away.
Right. Mm-hmm. And then I remember seeing the little girl from Hocus Pocus.
What?
What's her name? She's the daughter.
My what?
She's his daughter.
She's
right?
Is the brunette Thora Birch?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know she's in Hocus Pocus.
She's smaller in Hocus Pocus. And I remember this was the first time I was like seeing her again.
Mm.
And I was like, way to go.
I remember her as the girl from... the goth girl from that movie about Harvey Pekar, and I can't think of the name of it. No, it's like a comic book with Scarlett Johansson. Oh, I've really messed this up. I don't remember much of it at all. I just remember that they're in a movie together.
I don't know.
Before they were famous. Yeah.
She shows her boobs.
Oh my god, there's so many boobs in this movie. Well, lucky us.
Yeah, here we go.
Alright, we'll count the boobs for you.
Yeah, boob count for sure.
And a sadness count. We'll track the sadness.
We'll take a shot every time there's a boob.
Okay.
And sadness.
I have a mood tracker in my phone. I could track Kevin Spacey's mood. Yeah. see if we learn anything.
Yeah. Okay. That would be good.
This will be fun.
I'm excited.
All right. American Beauty. Here we go.
Yes. There's this whole industry, like, to make movies, but most of them are bad.
I know. It's like, how do they mess up that often?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think...
What was the last really good movie you saw? Right?
Man.
I don't know either.
I've seen some good ones. I really liked Hereditary a lot.
Hereditary was good and scared me.
I really liked Mother a lot, which I know is controversional.
I haven't seen it.
But I like horror movies, so I guess I just have a thing.
Thought Hereditary was really well done.
It was so good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I slept with the lights on. I was scared.
It is so interesting. I want to watch it again because it's one of those that, like, there's so many clues.
Yeah, definitely. Toni Collette's amazing.
Mm-hmm. She's so good. Mm-hmm. I love United States of Tara.
Me too.
Mm. There you go. Hocus Pocus, girl.
She's Hocus Pocus.
Oh, suburbs.
My name is Lester Burnham.
You know, where life's super hard.
Mm-hmm. This is my neighborhood. This is my street. This is my life. I'm 42 years old. In less than a year, I'll be dead.
Yeah, you already implied that.
Oh, I forgot that he, like, tells us he's gonna die.
I forgot that he dies.
Spoiler.
And in a way, I'm dead already.
He's so menacing.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Look at me. Jerking off in the shower.
No thanks, Louis C.K.
This will be the high point of my day. It's all downhill.
Doesn't he jerk off in this movie a lot?
I hope not. There might be more than that.
That's my wife.
Oh, yeah. Carol.
Is that the scene they showed when he was at the Oscars?
That's not an accident. That's our next door neighbor, Jim. And that's his lover, Jim.
Oh,
daring.
Jim and Jim.
Morning, Carolyn.
Oh, wait, who is that?
I love your tie, that collar.
Who? Which one?
The gay guy. Oh, Scott Bakula. From Quantum Leap.
Yeah, I was gonna say, was he Quantum Leap?
Uh huh.
I loved Quantum Leap.
Exhausted just watching her. She wasn't always like this. She used to be happy.
Yeah, so you ruined her.
Right.
We used to be happy.
He hates her.
Mm hmm.
My daughter Jane. Only child. Jane's a pretty typical teenager.
Angry, that was two boobies, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Two boobs so far.
Mm-hmm.
What are we, 5 minutes in?
Barely.
And I don't want to lie to her.
She wants smaller breasts?
I know, right?
I'm already out. How cute.
Oh my god, look at the pawns on their shoes.
I want them.
Seriously?
Did you buy any shoes with palms on them?
No.
Aww.
I didn't know those were available.
Can I get the American Beauty shoes?
Yeah, please. I think those are handmade. This isn't very good.
Right.
I mean, bring it on and come out by now.
I know. This is bring it on, the office. Mm-hmm. Office space.
Gross.
This is so gross.
Gross. Don't.
Can't hate his life, but like someone his own age.
Seriously? They went this far with it?
Yeah.
She's 16?
15?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let's get a close-up on his saggy eyelids. Also, that many people never go to a basketball game.
Don't know. Come on. Already?
Yeah, and then they do the read. So what do you think the roses are symbolism for?
Fucking. He didn't. Wes Bentley did not accuse Kevin Spacey of anything, but he did get real addicted to heroin right after this movie.
And that's that kid?
I'll meet you out front.
But, so you're saying it's not...
I'm just giving you two facts that I found on Google.
It's not related to Kevin.
No.
Okay.
No. Why would you try to numb the pain with a painkiller?
Right.
I'm just saying.
Why? I would be terrified.
What is she smiling about? Is she doing well at the Game Boy?
Yeah, she just passed the level.
She got a new score?
She likes that a guy is stalking her.
They all like that guys are stalking them. That's yeah, like the movie.
This guy's stalking
mm-hmm.
in his own way.
And...
he's a stalker.
Since she said that if his chest and arms were bigger, she'd suck his dick. So now he's gonna pump iron. Okay. Immediately, not like tomorrow.
Right.
Casually.
And he's not gonna change.
No. Well, yeah, he is.
In his dress shirt.
Wait, bro.
What is happening?
Whoa!
What?
No! Okay, I guess we have to throw a butt into the boob cat now.
Right, butt cat. Oh.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's all about posture.
Right, I know.
Wait, did he just comment on his own weird video making?
He said, America's weirdest home videos.
He can't have ironic distance from his creepy habit. I'm sorry.
Nobody commented on that.
Yeah, totally creepy on set.
Oh yeah, for sure. Uh-oh.
Coming, Dad.
Oh, I don't need another one of these dream sequences, and I don't need
There's
you.
There's gonna be like five more.
No, I got it already. He's obsessed with her young body. Get
Wait,
moving
is
on.
He going into their room? Ew!
No!
What?
Oh, it's a dream sequence.
Yeah, there's a lot of these. I'm with you. I get it too, but they're gonna keep doing this.
All right, I'm ready now. I'm mentally prepared in a way that I wasn't earlier.
That tub.
Those ferns. Those are so 90s. Okay, a couple things. First of all, this is way too plot heavy for a man's sex dream. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
There's suspense, there's lighting, there's scenery.
Just like...
yeah.
There's a narrative.
Yeah.
All right, it's reoccurring. Gross.
And Mina Savari was like literally only 20 something, 21. Yeah.
And this like rewind thing they do,
yeah,
also too much.
Well, she certainly did take advantage of the lifestyle.
I could use his eyebrows to dry off after a shower.
I know. They're so. I mean, he's got makeup on too.
When I saw you two at the party the other night, you seemed perfectly happy. Call me crazy.
Yeah, look at their terry cloth eyebrows.
Yeah, they're so thick.
One must project an image of success at all times.
Yes, facades. That's my thing too.
Right.
Yes, I am turned on.
I'll have what she's having.
By sociopaths. Oh, speaking of.
Right.
I was filming this dead bird.
Why?
Because it's beautiful.
Get it?
I think maybe you forgot your medication today, mental boy.
Hi, Jane.
Look, I want you to stop filming me.
This is kind of boring.
Yeah, it's so.
Are you crazy? I don't want to end up packed to pieces in a dumpster somewhere.
It's okay, I'll walk. But thanks.
Yeah, see, he doesn't want to go anyway. Come on, let's go.
The ear clippy piercing side.
Did you do that? I didn't. Yeah. I got the real piercing and then it deformed my ear.
Oh no.
Yeah. Seriously? See, like I got.
You got like a weird thing going there now?
Yeah, and then it like closed.
You let it go.
Yeah. But I should have done like just the fake.
The fake one, yeah, like she had.
Oh.
Wow. Flexible.
Is she okay?
Is she even there? Or is she underneath the bed like a magic trick?
I know. She's through the wall.
Well, now everybody's happy.
I know. You just had to...
Everybody just had to make a couple bad decisions and now they're happy.
No one has filters. Everyone just lets all their emotions out.
Yeah.
Drive with weed.
What?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
He can.
Oh my god.
It's like official state China of the Third Reich. It's a whole subculture of people who collect this Nazi shit.
They made their own plates?
But my dad just has this one thing.
Why? Did they put... That's not... Did they?
Can we go?
Can we? What?
Now it's gonna be.
What's a Nazi plate?
Nothing.
Can I buy a Nazi plate?
Don't get on a watch list just because of this movie.
On my Amazon wish list. Nazi plate.
Regular plate, swastika on the back. That's right. All. Nothing too Nazi. Just subtle.
Right.
Yeah. Filming the trash. Instead of picking it up.
This is so dumb.
All of these people were considered interesting.
It was one of those days.
Right.
20 years ago.
It's a minute away from snowing.
Did the internet save us?
I think so. We would have been this.
I think so.
No.
Also, the resolution on the cameras back then would not have looked this good.
Was the plastic bag nominated for an Oscar?
I don't remember. Best prop.
15 minutes.
15 minutes? Why do you like this guy?
Why did they move there? How could they afford that house? Is he still in the Marines? His wife obviously doesn't work. These are very nice homes. Kevin Spacey only makes $60,000 a year. That doesn't seem sufficient. Not even in the 90s. Oh, also more boobies, huh?
Boob count.
Boob count's gonna go up to what?
Also, why is she...
Yeah, she's fine.
So she wanted a reduction?
I guess. It must.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Let the hair down.
That's important.
That's what society tells you to do. My hair cannot be up if my top's off.
It's really especially creepy that he's got the live feed on the TV. I don't know why. I know.
It's like a Best Buy.
Yeah. Don't. Ugh. No. Ah! Kill him!
It's root beer.
No.
Did you say kill him? Yeah. Kill him now.
Kill him.
This is too much for you, the underage drinking. The whole movie was fine, but...
No, just the, like... manipulation.
Oh, okay.
I mean, the fantasizing was already pushing it, but the actual, like, here, have some alcohol, minor, while I touch you.
Cool.
And exploit your vulnerable moment.
But he's the hero.
No.
I don't know.
This is so weird to watch because he is this. This is his...
I know. Ah! They should take the Oscar away.
Did they?
Well, because it's him.
I know.
He's not even acting.
I feel like... I guess they don't do that, but they really should.
Yeah.
No. Oh. Ugh.
Last semester.
That's a...
No.
And that's a new. Because I'm only judging you on your surface features and youthful age.
So gross.
She's clearly not into this.
She's just sad and scared.
Yeah.
Gross. No. Kill him.
Kill him.
Please kill him now. I refuse to be a victim. Oh, God. Lester,
I have something I have to say to you.
Oh, buddy, this movie sucks harder than I remember.
I know. We should have watched Titanic.
It would have taken an hour and a half longer, but it would have been worth it. Don't touch her. Ugh.
I know, it's like...
How is this okay?
And they, like, drag it out.
In soft lighting, like, it's totally fine. Like, strip away the pretty piano music and put on some harsh lighting and stop the slow motion and all that, and this gets real, like...
Thunder and lightning. It's real scary.
It's horrifying. This is a horror movie.
Where are they?
Upstairs!
What?
From them!
My parents will try to find me.
You gotta leave! I thought you were gonna leave to New York. Oh no.
No. The obsession with the boobs. There we go.
Two more.
Two more. What are we at? Six? Six plus a butt?
Six plus a butt.
You're kidding. I'm sorry. I still
the one that do it. I just thought I should tell you, in case you wondered why I wasn't.
Like, she's a virgin.
Better. Yeah.
Ugh.
And that kicks his conscience in?
Well, he's gonna lay on a breast first.
That's what's important.
What's wrong? I thought you said it was beautiful.
You are beautiful. You are so beautiful. And I would be a very lucky man.
No, bad person.
I feel so stupid.
Don't.
Oh my god, you've already... just going this far was wrong. You're not redeeming yourself. You've already fucked her up. It's sexual assault.
No.
You are a bad person. Oh, kill him. Just kill him.
I think that's what they're trying to do, like, make him look like a good guy.
They're trying to make him look like a victim, but you know what? He is not a victim.
He's
today.
Not.
You are not a victim.
He is not a victim.
No, 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 I'm fine.
You sure?
I'm still a little weirded out, but...
Yeah, that's
I feel
gonna...
better about the way you groomed me.
No,
now.
You're going to be weirded out for a long time.
How's Jane?
Wow, she is flying through the stages of grief. Jesus, I think she just hit six in that one move.
Well, it's like murder.
Oh, that was a bad haircut. Why are you remembering that haircut?
Of
the bag.
I'm pretty pissed off about what happened to me. But it's hard to stay mad when there's so much beauty in the world.
Oh, he turned into a paper bag. A plastic bag.
That's what happens when you die.
Mm-hmm. If you're a piece of white trash.
You turn into white trash.
You float out to the Pacific Ocean where you choke a whale with your useless body. Just like you did in life, you flabby asshole.
And I can't feel anything but gratitude.
Oh, good.
Oh, isn't that nice?
You have no idea what I'm talking about, I'm sure.
Oh, you're condescending in death.
You will someday.
Fuck you.
I like the threat.
Yeah, seriously.
The threat.
Kevin Spacey's gonna kill us all.
Sam Mendes.
Well, the direction was good.
Ugh.
The writing was terrifying.
It was so bad. Alan Ball.
All right. I don't need to listen to this glee club. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
We're so upset. Are you okay?
She's...
Oh, no.
I'm literally choking on this movie's white privilege for starters.
I know. It was so bad.
Okay. How do you even start?
Okay, so I remember when this movie came out,
yeah,
and everyone was talking about how beautiful it was, mm-hmm, how great it was, and it's just awful.
It's pretty.
Where?
If you subtract
bag?
The content, just look.
If you mute it.
Yeah, and don't pay attention to what the characters are doing to and against each other, then it's... well shot.
I'm not gonna agree.
Whatever. No, yeah, everybody went gaga. I think every person in this movie who wasn't already famous got famous because of the movie. Like the two girls did.
Yeah.
I mean, Mina Suvari was a thing for a minute. And Thora Birch became like someone who was in three more movies and then disappeared.
She's always gonna be Hocus Pocus to me.
Yeah. Ghost World, that's what I was trying to think of.
Oh, she was in Ghost World.
Yeah, with Scarlett Johansson before either one was like... Anyway, and then...
she kept the Halloween
Chris
theme.
Cooper, I don't think he was like known before this movie.
Yeah, I think he hit like a big like stride in those, like...
Yeah, in those years. Yeah. Starting with this movie. Yeah.
Yeah. And he was always, like, a military guy, I feel like I remember.
Or just, yeah, very, like, squinty. He's just squinty. Right.
He's squinty.
Yeah. And then Allison Janney, I think she was on West Wing at that point, but, like...
I'm glad. Yeah. I'm glad she had the least amount of lines.
She had nothing to do with the story, which was good for her.
Yeah, I'm like still a fan, and but I feel like also a waste of her. Like,
yes,
I feel like anybody else could have done that role.
Yes,
because I'm like, you're not even letting her do her thing.
She's not letting her do anything.
Right. She stood, held a plate.
Yeah.
Asked what time it was.
But what was interesting is I had so much more empathy for her because I was like, hey, everybody, stop treating Allison Janney like that.
Right.
Let her do her thing, you know?
Yeah.
And then Wes Bentley, he was an Interstellar, so he's like had a comeback. But he went on to have a serious heroin addiction.
Yeah, you told me that. We looked it up.
I didn't know that either. I thought maybe he had said something about Kevin Spacey because it was clear. Okay, let's just fucking do the Kevin Spacey.
Right, right.
All right. So here's the revelation that we have watching this movie 20 years later. Mm-hmm. Kevin Spacey plays in this movie Kevin Spacey.
Yeah. Yes. He's playing Kevin Spacey. It's super uncomfortable. And that's the thing. It's like I was remembering, and then as we're watching it, I'm like, yeah, they're making him the fucking hero.
Yeah.
And he's not.
He's not. He's an awful person.
Yeah.
And the fact that he got killed is not a tragedy. It's just long overdue at that point. It's too late. He's already broken several people.
Right. And yeah. It's like, well, he died happy.
Good for him.
Right.
So I'm sure he's happy now.
Because he took charge and got what he wanted.
That's the thing. Right. So he plays someone who's attracted to underage people.
Right.
Creeps on them, grooms them, and then becomes extremely selfish and expects everyone to be proud of him for that. And then at the end is killed like his career, but somehow... somehow gets to remain like famous and alive in his own way, still narrating even after he dies.
I'm sure he's gonna be in another thing.
He's gonna have a fucking comeback.
I'm sure. So, okay, the roses.
Oh, and one more thing.
Oh, what?
Because there's a gay subplot, which in itself was kind of like nice and progressive for the late 90s, I guess, or whatever.
Sure.
But they use it to propel the death plot. In a way, Kevin Spacey's only redemption is at the very end somebody thinks he's gay, which is what he tried to do in real life.
Ugh. It was too weird.
It was awful.
It was too weird.
I'm so mad about this movie.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
The roses.
Let's talk about roses.
I don't understand why there were so many roses.
Okay. Well, roses equal women.
Oh, okay.
Because the wife makes roses.
Yeah.
But he resents those roses because they're well-groomed and well-taken care of. Uh-huh. What he wants is those free-flying titty roses. From a 16-year-old. Right. Yeah.
I forget that roses have titties.
Roses aren't... They don't have them. They're of them.
Oh, I see.
They are tit-based organisms.
Right. I'm, like, still waiting for the day I open my shirt and roses spill out of me.
I know.
Wouldn't that be great?
Me too. I just have thorns.
Just, yeah, same. Yeah. Thorns. I got a lot of weeds.
Yeah. I've got a bush. I don't know if that helps. Just,
oh, God. Yeah. It was a lot of white privilege.
Yeah.
It's funny.
Everybody kind of does whatever they want, including breaking several laws.
Oh, yeah.
And the only consequence is homophobia.
Right. That was the... Wow.
Which doesn't even visit itself upon the two extremely nearby gay people.
Yeah, I'm glad. Yeah, I'm so glad they weren't affected.
It's kind of satisfying that only straight people were hurt by the homophobia.
Yeah, I love it. And the gyms, they're still successful in their home.
They're totally fine. They stood up for themselves fairly well.
Right.
Yeah, that was the part where it was like written by Alan Ball. I'm like, oh, good for you.
Right.
You know, putting your people in and then taking them right back out before things got too real.
I hope they get better neighbors.
Well, they still have
in the future.
I mean, unless they catch Sergeant Sam.
Oh, right. There's going to be a part two.
I guess. I don't. Yeah. American Beauty 2. This time the gays get it from another closeted gay this time.
But there's a lot of movies where it's like about white people that are sad about their mundane lives.
Yeah, that's weird. Why is that?
That's a big.
Why do white people get sad movies?
I don't know. Why are they so sad?
I'm honestly trying to think, like, if there's ever been a drama about an African American or any person of color, the Asian, Hispanic, any family, where the plot is just that they're sad and they have to work through it.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, I feel like...
I can't think of...
No.
A one.
There's always... There has to be, like, something else.
It has to be more...
Right. Like, Moonlight was about being gay.
Yeah, I haven't seen that one yet, but...
Oh, I ruined it.
Well, I knew that part. And I've only deliberately not seen it because I know I have to watch it for this podcast eventually when it comes out.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah.
That's right, it won.
It did eventually.
Eventually, yeah. Yep.
But yeah, I guess that's true. Maybe that came close. We'll find out.
Yeah, but I think like there has to be like something. Like it can't just be like an African-American family like, oh, it's, and like our life is hard as
having
is.
Having a non, like, I don't know, like... Having a midlife crisis.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, and then like, I'm trying to
think.
Some
plays that are kind of along those lines, you know?
But I feel like most of them, if it's like a family of color, it's a comedy.
That's true.
Like, it's like, well, because this is funny what they're going through.
It's a comedy, or there's like something, you're like, right, like there's extreme poverty or extreme wealth, or like there's no just like middle class normal problems.
Slice of life.
Existential crisis that matters.
Right.
Everything has to be surface.
Like cheating on the spouses.
With terry cloth eyebrows.
Those eyebrows, though.
I can't. I'm actually. There has to be at least one, and I'm like dying to. There's a couple movies I haven't seen. I'm not really sure what they're about. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know how Stella got her groove back. Waiting to Exhale. Those are come to mind. To like female centered, but
right. I've seen. It's been a long time since I've seen Waiting to Exhale.
Yeah.
That didn't win any awards.
Oh, God, winning award. That's a whole other thing. Like, getting awards for stories about not white people? That's been...
You're right.
Trust me, I've seen a lot of these.
Oh, yeah. All these Oscar movies are... Oh, should I get them?
That'd be nice. No. I mean, it's just less creepy when the screensaver kicks in if they were not in the dark.
I guess, was Moonlight the first one?
No.
No.
They're mostly recent, though, where there's people who are main characters who get real stories told who aren't white.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's an equal balancing amount of blackface in this back catalog of
I'm sure.
Best Picture winners, so it still feels kind of...
Yeah.
There's a ways to go.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Academy...
I've yet to see a movie with an Asian person in it for this podcast, for example.
Wow.
Not even like bad stereotypical yellow face.
Anything. Yeah.
So, yeah.
It's
some of these white people, these fucking white people. This movie was super white. I did not remember.
It was so white. There was no... Nothing. It was just white people, two gays... But then a third, surprise gay at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was so... I think the dialogue was so cheesy.
It did feel like a TV show.
And the, all of the teenagers were very self-aware of their situations.
At the beginning.
Yeah.
And then at the end, they were like 10. Right. They were just yelling at each other.
Yeah, I like right before Kevin Spacey assaults her.
Yes.
She's like, "You're a kid." And she's like, "Yeah. You're a kid too." And it's like, "Yeah, we're kids."
Then, oh, yeah. No. "You're a loser butt," or whatever she said. Yeah,
lame-o.
A lame-o.
Yeah. Yeah, this movie, I want to go back and like read reviews. How could like nobody, when was this?
98, 99.
Nobody was like, "This is weird." Like, did we all have like some just like blinders on?
I think there were fewer voices in the world when this movie came out. I mean, I was only kidding when I said, did the internet fix us? Because right. I think the media at that time was so white dominant.
Yeah.
And there was, you know, the AOL was our internet. There wasn't like Google and like all that stuff yet. That cultural criticism was very tilted. And shit like this, just blindness. Like people didn't see it.
They're like, "It's cool."
Because the people talking about it were all those people who were in the movie.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's, it's us and our problems. We should take these seriously instead of taking a step back and going, "What the fuck?
Right. Why are we like normalizing this?" Or like,
yes.
And it's like, this is like a real story about real people. And it's like, we know there's creepy dudes in the suburbs that prey on teenage girls.
I mean,
but like, let's make it like, let's romanticize it.
There's not a single dude in this movie who's not at some point violating a girl with her pleasure. Like, and where she doesn't turn around and go, "Thank you for noticing me." You know, instead of being like, anyway.
Yeah, every woman in this was
pleased to be sexually abused.
Right.
And well, Annette Bening wasn't abused, but she was totally all in for the adultery. But you know what? You go, girl.
Yeah.
That one was okay.
Because
Kevin Spacey treated her like such dirt. It's like, why not get with Terry Cloth Eyebrows and put your legs in the air? You know?
I'm saying, and that's the thing, like, I wanted to root for her, but then they, like, they kept making her the bad guy.
They did. I mean, like
Nagy. And it's just like, no, she's right. Like, he is a piece of shit. And he, like, he's like, "Oh, I want as little responsibility as possible." It's like, well, tough shit. You're a fucking grown up and you have a kid.
Yeah.
You can.
So hold on. The end of this movie, it is kind of interesting story-wise how they make it a who will do it instead of a whodunit. Kind of by like setting up, he gets murdered, and then there's like five people we have to check off which one of them did it. No pun on check off. So if you think about that, though, if you take one step back and think about that, everyone in this movie wanted Kevin Spacey dead.
True.
Plausibly, everybody in this movie wanted him to die.
This is true.
How is he the hero of this movie?
I didn't think about it that way.
I think he's remembered as a protagonist, as like the person whose story we're watching, instead of like this horrifying character who everybody needs to get rid of out of their lives because he's just so toxic.
Yeah, he's super toxic and fucking with all of them with his like, "Wah, y'all are messing my life." It's like, then just go.
Go work at your Shoney's or whatever. Go flip it a Whataburger without us.
Yeah. But it's like everyone else is the bad guy.
Yeah.
The kid, what's his name?
Wes Bentley?
Yeah.
What's his name in the movie? Who cares?
Yeah, I forget his... The freak.
Freaky kid.
Freaky kid. the bad kid. He liked him.
That's true, but he also offered to kill him for money.
Oh, that's right.
So that's why he was a suspect.
I wonder if any of my friends would like turn on me like that too, if they were offered money to
Well, it's dads. You know how we were just talking earlier about how it's hard to keep your friends off your dads?
Oh, right.
That cuts both ways. You know, sometimes to keep your friends from fucking your dad, you gotta hire another friend to kill him.
That's right. It's only one or the other.
Yeah. That's the American part of American Beauty.
Yeah. They said, I love that she actually told her friend, could you just not fuck my dad or what?
Yeah. I think she said that word.
Or can you just not have sex with my dad, please? And it was just like, what?
And then the fight continued.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't just like, I wasn't going to. It was like, what if I want to? I'm a model.
Right. She's like, no, you can't tell me what to do. This whole movie was messed up. And
the only thing that keeps Kevin Spacey from statutory rape is the idea that she's a virgin. That's where this movie's morals are.
Yeah.
It's like, that would be something that would make you stop and think. Not the statutory rape that was going on actively.
Yeah.
That, like, oh, well, I can't be the first, but if she's already a slut, go for it, plow that field. That was the morals of this movie.
It was like, he's like, no, I'm looking for someone with experience.
Exactly. He's like, if I'm going to fuck a teen, I want it to be good.
Yeah, that's exactly what they were doing. And, like, I hate that they make that scene, like, again, they're like, look what a good guy he is. He stopped it because she was like, I'm a virgin.
Yeah, that's the thing that the morals of this that feels really outdated is that the movie thinks he went to the brink of doing something bad.
Yeah.
When clearly he had crossed that. He had gone into bad way earlier.
Yeah, no.
Like seven steps earlier.
Far past the line.
Yeah.
And then she's like, I feel dumb. And he's like, I'll make you a grilled cheese. And she's like, okay.
Now I feel better. You've really helped me process this experience, Mr. Assault Man.
Right. This is not going to be scarring at all. And then...
And look at Kevin Spacey's smug fucking smile because this is his fucking life. He's like, lives with it. He got to act out
his own crime.
And then later in his career, got to act out his own crime and come across like a hero. This must have felt like a great... Did he win? Did he win for this movie?
I think so.
Oh, I think he did.
I think Annette Bening did too.
Oh, God damn it.
I feel like
Annette Bening was fine. It's not her fault that the script is trying to turn. She acted her ass
off. I think this was one of the movies that like won all the awards, you know?
Oh, God.
That like takes it all home.
Hold on. Accolades. That sounds right, doesn't it?
Kevin Spacey.
It was nominated for 8 of them. And best picture, best actor, Kevin Spacey, best screenplay for that piece of shit by Alan Ball.
That dialogue was shit.
Best cinematography. I told you.
I don't agree.
And best director for Sam Mendes, which I don't know. That's fine. He's gone on to do really good movies.
Do you think it's because we're in the future now and it's 2018? And we're like, oh, your 90s films were trash.
Yes. Like,
they're all trash now, too, though.
I mean, I saw this theater. I saw this movie in the theaters. It was in my zone. I was there living that life.
Yeah.
I was like 20, 21 when it came out. And I remember watching it and going, wow, that was an amazing movie.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's nominated for Academy Awards. That makes sense. Kevin Spacey was really good in it. We were all just fucking floating through life. I thought
that too, yeah.
I mean, it wasn't like we missed it. I get it. The culture has changed a ton.
Yeah.
But how quickly and how much it's changed in 20 years to make this movie seem so physically violent and gross.
Yeah, I don't think...
From the very beginning.
Right. It wouldn't work at all now.
No.
Like, I think the people would quickly be like, no.
It's like we didn't know we were racist, and we made a bunch of movies with racist shit in it, and then, like, later looked back, and we're like, oops, yikes.
We're racist.
Wow, we were really racist. Yeah. I feel like that's how we are with the way women are treated in these stories about sad men.
Yeah.
It's become, I mean, and I'm not excusing myself. I didn't see it.
Yeah, I didn't. I mean, I saw the movie too, and I was just like, this is great. But I feel like now when I watch like movies and like a lot of roles women are in now, like
yeah.
90s movies, 80s movies, and I'm like, all of these roles suck.
Yeah.
Like,
they're so awful. I feel yeah. really bad for all the famous actresses of the 80s and 90s.
Yeah.
Because not a damn one of them got a worthwhile part.
But I remember watching them being like, that's cool. Or yeah. like, this is great.
Ugh.
I don't know. Was 9 to 5 good?
9 to 5 was good. Yeah, 9 to 5 was a little broad.
Right.
No pun intended again. But yeah, I mean.
They killed the guy.
They told, well, did they kill him?
No.
I think they kidnapped him and tortured him, right. sort of. With the light rat. Torture, like Home Alone style light torture.
Right.
Yeah.
Not shot in the head, like.
Yeah, that was the thing. If there was a girl power movie, it was like cartoony.
Right.
But there were a couple. I don't know.
I know this. My pick was very depressing.
It wasn't your pick. This was foisted on both of us by fate.
So I picked numbers and you also picked numbers?
You pick numbers and the numbers pick the movie, but you don't know.
I don't know.
You're just throwing numbers out there.
It's my fault. Well, I will not be a victim. It's what this movie has taught me. She listens to tapes in the car. Are yeah. there podcasts that do that?
Yeah, of course. Are there self-help podcasts?
Yeah.
I should have listed this as a self-help podcast. We'd be doing so much better.
I will not be a victim.
You will not be a victim. If you're listening to this, you will not be a victim.
And that was all the tapes she was listening to said.
Yeah.
I will not be a victim.
And ironically, that's all any of these women needed to hear.
Right. They were all...
Vanessa, do you have anything coming up that you want to tell people about or anything that people can look you up and enjoy your art
with? I'll be on True TV's Laugh Mob Laugh Tracks on November 1st.
Wow, cool.
Yeah.
That sounds awesome.
That's coming up.
You guys should see Vanessa perform. She's so good.
No.
She's my hero.
No.
Yes, and we get to do a show tomorrow, which is in the past for you people.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
That. Yeah, we're gonna have a good time.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you so much for coming on.
Thanks for having me. No more Kevin Spacey.
No, we're done. This was our final Kevin Spacey that we had to like digest and push through our system, and now we're inoculated.
I need to go watch a Tom Hanks movie to cleanse.
Very good call. Please rate us or like us or just keep listening to us. I don't care what you do. Do what you want to do. You're not a victim.
Right.
See you next week. Bye.